मैं कमल सिंह, सीएलसी मैथ्स फैकल्टी। तो जेई एडवांस 2019 वीडियो सॉल्यूशन पेपर फर्स्ट मैथ्स के न्यूमेरिकल वैल्यू टाइप क्वेश्चंस को डिस्कस करेंगे। अब फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन सॉल्व करेंगे न्यूमेरिकल वैल्यू टाइप क्वेश्चंस का। फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन है, लेट द पॉइंट बी विद द रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ द पॉइंट ए 2, 3 विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द लाइन 8x माइनस 6y माइनस 23 इज इक्वल टू 0। लेट गामा ए एंड गामा बी विद द सर्कल्स ऑफ द रेडियस 2 एंड 1 विद द सेंटर ए एंड बी रिस्पेक्टिवली। लेट टी बी द कॉमन टेंजेंट टू द सर्कल्स, टी इज द कॉमन टेंजेंट टू बोथ द सर्कल गामा ए एंड गामा बी, सो दैट द बोथ द सर्कल्स आर ऑन द सेम साइड ऑफ टी। इफ सी इज द पॉइंट ऑफ इंटरसेक्शन ऑफ द टी, सो सी इज द पॉइंट ऑफ इंटरसेक्शन ऑफ द टी एंड द लाइन पासिंग थ्रू द ए एंड बी, देन द लेंथ ऑफ द लाइन सेगमेंट ए सी we have to find out. So now first we take the reflection of point B about the line 8x minus 6y. First we take the reflection of point A 2, 3 about the line 8x minus 6y minus 23 is equal to 0, which is given as here we have x minus 2 upon 8 and y minus 3 upon minus 6 and minus 2. Here we have 16 minus 18 and minus 23 upon 100. By solving this equation, we have x is equal to here 6 and y is equal to 0. So the coordinates of the point B, which is the reflection of point A 2, 3 about this line. So B is given here 6, 0. Now we draw the both the circles gamma A and gamma B. Clear? So the radius of the gamma circle, gamma A, is here we have 2, and the radius of the gamma B is 1. So now the diagram for both the circles is given as this one. This is gamma A and this is gamma B. Clear? Now there is a common tangent to both the circles. There is a common tangent to both the circles. Here we have T. So now both the circles are on same side of this tangent T. The tangent T is produced further in this way. Now line joining the centers of the gamma A is A and center of the gamma B is B. So line joining the both the centers is further produced, and this line meets the tangent at point C. At point C. Clear? Now the radius of this circle is we have 2, and radius of this circle this is 1, and we assume these points as a P, Q. Now we have to find out, the question is here, we have to find out the AC. So we take the two triangles here. One triangle is the PAC and other triangle is the P, second triangle is the we have the QBC. So both the triangle are similar triangle. Now we have to find out the AC. So coordinates of point A is here 2, 3, and coordinates of point B is 6, 0. Now distance between these two points is 5. Clear? So now triangle APC is similar to triangle APC is similar to triangle BQC. So we take their ratio of their corresponding sides. So AP upon BQ is equal to AC upon BC. So BC you further can have, BC will be equal to AC minus AB. So this is AC upon AC minus AB. So this we have 2 upon 1 and AC upon AC minus 5. So by solving this equation, we have AC is equal to 10. So this is the answer for this question. Clear? Now the next question. Now come to the second question. Let S be the sample space of all 3 into 3 matrices with the entries from this set having the two elements 0, 1. Let the events E1 and E2 be given by E1. E1 is the set of those matrices A, whose determinant value A is, determinant value is 0. Now E2 is the second set of the matrices A. The sum of the entries, sum of all the elements in each matrix is 7 here. And if the matrix, if a matrix is selected at random from S, then conditional probability of the PE1 upon E2 equals. So we have to find out that this is the conditional probability. Clear? Now first we find out the how many matrices are there in set E2. So E2 is, here we have the those matrices which are having the sum of the elements is 7. Clear? Now for E2, the elements for each matrix will be as 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0. Clear? So these are the 9 elements, and 7 of them will be, each element will be unity. Clear? And 2 elements will be 0. Clear? Now, using these 9 elements, so how many matrices are possible there for E2? So the number of matrices in E2, in set E2, is given by the here 9C2. So using simply the number of arrangements, how many arrangements can be made by using these 9 elements, that is 9C2. So that is 36 here, 36. Now the total number of matrices in set E2 we have 36. The sum of all the elements, sum of the all the entries is here we have 7. Clear? Now for event E1, E1 is the further we have set. Clear? Containing those matrices whose determinant value is given equal to, whose determinant value is equal to 0. Clear? So first we take, for example, so in this way, so the determinant of, determinant value of that matrix is 0. So for example, first we take the matrix in this way, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, here 0, 0, 1. Clear? So value, determinant value of this matrix is, here we have 0. Determinant value of this matrix is 0. If we expand it by the R3, so its value will be 0. Now, in third row, these elements can be arranged in three ways. Clear? So similarly, this row can be shifted in second row. Third row can take the here the place of the second row, and second row can take here the third place, third row. So by shifting this row in first row, second row, clear? So how many matrices will be there? So their determinant value will be 0. So in this case, we will have number of matrices will be 3 into 3, that is 9. When two elements of one row containing two zeros, clear? And further, there is one more case here. In this way, when the two elements of one column having zero, two zeros, and remaining columns are having all the elements unity, clear? Now its value will be here, we have determinant value will be 0. Its determinant value. So similarly, in this first column, we can arrange, in first column, we can arrange these three elements in three ways. So if we take the elements of the second column, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1. So now further we have three more matrices whose determinant will be 0. And similarly, if third elements of the third column having the element 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1. So then determinant value of matrix again will be 0. So how many number of matrices will be there whose determinant value will be 0? So number of matrices, in this case, number of matrices will be 3 into 3, that is 9. Clear? How many number of matrices are there How many number of matrices are there which are whose determinant value is 0? So number of matrices having determinant value 0, 18. Clear? Now these 18 matrices also contained in E2. Clear? Why? Because each matrix is having the 7, 1 and 2 zeros. So these matrices are also contained in E2. Clear? So how many number of matrices are there in E1? So we have 18. So how many common matrices are there in E1 and E2? And E1 intersection E2, we have 18. So required probability will be here, the condition probability, the PE1 upon E2 is given by PE1 upon E2 will be here, N E1 intersection E2 upon N E2. So this we have equal to 18 upon 36, and this is 0.5. So this is the answer for second question, 0.5. Clear? Now next question. So here we have third question. Three lines are given by r vector, lambda I cap, lambda belongs to r vector, mu I plus j cap, mu belongs to r, and third line is given r vector v I cap plus j cap plus k cap, v belongs to here r. Let the lines cut the plane x plus y plus z is equal to 1 at the points A, B and C respectively. If the area of the triangle ABC is delta, then value of 6 delta whole square equal. So in this question, first we take all the three lines in Cartesian form. Clear? So first line is given by here we have x upon 1, y upon 0, z upon 0. So second line will be x upon 1, y upon 1, z upon 0. So second line is here in this way. So third line, x upon 1, y upon 1, z upon 1. So these three lines we have converted into Cartesian form. So we have to find out the point of intersection of these three lines with the plane x plus y plus z is equal to 1. So point of intersection with plane x plus y plus z is equal to 1. Is plane ke saath mein aapko पॉइंट ऑफ इंटरसेक्शन निकालना है तीनों लाइंस का. जब हम पॉइंट ऑफ इंटरसेक्शन निकालेंगे तो पहले इसके साथ में इसको किसके बराबर रखेंगे हम, R1 के, ठीक है, इसके R2 के, R3 के. तो पहले आप जब इस लाइन का पॉइंट ऑफ इंटरसेक्शन निकालेंगे इसमें, तो इसमें क्या आएगा, इसका पॉइंट ऑफ इंटरसेक्शन क्या लिखेंगे, R1 0 0. इसमें जब डालेंगे तो क्या आएगा आपके पास में, R1 + 0 + 0 = 1. तो ये आपके पास में R1 की वैल्यू कितनी होगी, 1. तो पॉइंट ऑफ इंटरसेक्शन क्या आ गया, A, 1 0 0. तो सिमिलरली x प्लस y प्लस z का इस सेकंड लाइन का इसके साथ में पॉइंट ऑफ इंटरसेक्शन आपका क्या आएगा, तो इसी तरीके से B के कोऑर्डिनेट्स क्या आ जाएंगे. तो जैसे 1 इसमें क्या रखोगे आप, R2 + R2 0, 1. तो 2R2 is equal to 1. So R2 is equal to 1 upon 2. So B point will be 1 upon 2, 1 upon 2, 0. So similarly, for C, now point of intersection of this line, point of intersection of this line with this plane, that is C. So C is given by 1/3, 1/3, 1/3. So in this way, we have found the point of intersection of all these three lines with this plane. Clear? So, अब आपने को क्या करना है? अब these three points form a triangle ABC. So we find out the in the form of vector. AB vector is given by we have AB vector will be -1/2 i cap and +1/2 j cap and BC vector is given by BC vector. So 1/3 -1/2 that is -1/6 i cap and -1/6 j cap. So इस तरीके से +1/3 k cap. So area of triangle क्या आएगा? Delta is equal to 1/2 AB vector cross BC vector. इस तरीके से हम क्या ट्राइंगल का एरिया निकालेंगे. ये आपके पास में इसको फाइनली जब आप सॉल्व करोगे तो √3/12 आएगा. दिस विल बी √3/12. सो नाउ व्हाट विल बी द 6 डेल्टा होल स्क्वायर. सो दिस इज 6√3/12 होल स्क्वायर. सो 3/4 दिस इज 0.75. सो आंसर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन इज 0.75. क्लियर है? Now come to the fourth question. Fourth question, let omega is not equal to 1. Let this omega is not equal to 1 be a cube root of unity, then the minimum value of this set a plus b omega plus c omega square and this quantity is having the modulus whole square. Clear? A, b, c distinct non-zero integers equal. So square of the modulus of a plus b omega plus c omega square. Now you have to find out its minimum value. So a plus b omega plus c omega square whole square is given as a plus b omega plus c omega square and a plus b omega plus c omega square using the properties of the complex number. So modulus of z square is equal to z z bar. So we are using this property here. Clear? Ab isme now a plus b omega plus c omega square. So this we have a plus b omega bar plus c omega square bar. So omega bar will be here. Omega bar we have here. So 1 upon omega bar will be here omega square. So omega is the cube root of unity. So omega bar will be here omega square. And omega square bar, so bar of the omega square, that is omega in this way. So a plus b omega plus c omega square and a plus b omega square plus c omega. So if you solve this all, inko solve karte hain, to hamare paas mein kya aata hai? A square plus b square plus c square minus ab minus bc minus ca. Further simplifying it, so this can be given as, इसको फिर आगे simplify करते हैं, तो हमारे पास में क्या आता है? A minus B whole square plus B minus C whole square plus C minus A whole square. Bracket closed. Now according to question, A, B, C distinct non-zero integers. So अब इसमें A, B, C all are क्या? Distinct integers हैं. So now for distinct integers, its minimum value will be here 1. Minimum value will be 1. And similarly here, these are the B and C may be the consecutive integers. So its minimum value will be 1. So now if their difference is this is 1, 1 here we have, the difference will be 2. Why? If we take A, B, C are the three consecutive integers. So here we will have the, their difference will be 2. So now what will the minimum value of this will be? 1 upon 2, 1 plus 1 plus here 4. So this will be 3. So now minimum a plus b omega plus c omega square. So minimum value of this one is we have 3. So minimum value of this expression is 3. Now answer 2 for this, answer for this question is 3. Now come to the fifth question. This is the very simple question. So definite integral. So I is equal to, here we have 2 upon pi. So having the limits from definite integral, having the limits from minus pi by 4 to pi by 4, and dx upon 1 plus e raised to power sin x, 2 minus cos x, 2 minus cos 2x. So then you have to find out the value of this. So simply here we have, first we have the limit is from numerically left, numerically we have the lower limit and upper limit is same numerically, but having the opposite sign. So simply first we have to use here the King rule in this case. So as we know, if we have I is equal to, here we have a to b fx dx, and I is further we have a to b f a plus b minus x dx. So 2i is equal to a, having the, if we add these two, this is the King rule. So according to some rule, definite integral rule, clear, adding these two fx plus f a plus b minus x. So same this condition, same this condition will be applied to this definite integral. So 2i will be here. So my 2 upon pi. So same this rule will be applied to this. So minus pi by 4 to pi by 4. So we have, so dx upon me, kya aega? 1 plus e raised to power sin x, 2 minus cos 2x plus 1 upon plus 1 upon 1 plus e raised to power minus sin x in this way. So 2 minus cos 2x. So here we have 1 upon 2 minus cos 2x is common, and solving these two, if we solve these two, अगर हम इन दोनों का सम निकालेंगे तो इसकी वैल्यू आपको 1 मिलेगी. तो यहां से आपके पास में 2 अपॉन पाई, तो माइनस पाई बाय 4 टू पाई बाय 4. तो ये आपके पास में, ये किसके फॉर्म में आएगा? 1 के फॉर्म में आ जाएगा. तो सिंपली ये किसके बराबर आएगा? तो 1 अपॉन 2 माइनस कोस 2 एक्स डी एक्स. इसको जब आप क्या है, 1 अपॉन 1 प्लस ई रेज पर साइन एक्स प्लस 1 अपॉन 1 प्लस ई रेज पर माइनस साइन एक्स, इसको जब आप ऐड करोगे तो दिस विल गिव यू दी 1. तो फाइनली इसमें क्या आएगा? dx upon 2 minus cos 2x. क्लियर है? नाउ दिस इज इवन फंक्शन, ये इवन फंक्शन है. तो ये सिंपली किसके इक्वल आएगा? 4 upon pi, लिमिट विल बी चेंज फ्रॉम 0 to pi by 4 बिकॉज दिस इज द इवन फंक्शन. सो 0 to pi by 4. सो dx upon 2 minus cos 2x. सो इफ यू सॉल्व दिस, so 2i, if we solve this applying simple, now this is simple integration. So now here we have the I is equal to, so 2 upon 3 root 3. Very simple, change this cos 2x in terms of the 1 minus tan square x upon 1 plus tan square x. So by solving this you will have I is equal to 2 upon 3 root 3. So now we have to find out the 27 I square. So 27 4 upon 27. So answer is to this question is 4. So answer to this question is 4. Very simple. Clear? Now come to the next question, sixth question. In sixth question, we have let A be clear hai? And A is to D. So for this we have denote this A and D, denote here this set of all the terms of an infinite arithmetic progression with first term A. Their first term is A and common difference D greater than 0. Clear hai? So increasing, matlab, this is the now increasing AP. D greater than 0 shows here the increasing AP. Now first AP is here. First AP, we have AP, first AP in which the first term is the 1 and common difference is 3. So if you write down the first AP in this way, so first term is 1 and common difference is 3. So 1, 4, 7 in this way. So common difference is 3 here, 10. So this will continue. So there will be a sum term 52 here. Ek term aisa aayega, isme 52 aayega. So for second AP, here we have for second AP. So first, in which the first term is 2 and common difference is 5. So this is 2, 7 and 12, 17. This process continues. Again, this AP will also contain here one term equal to 52. Now third AP is here, 3, first term is 3 and common difference is 7, 3, 10, 13 and this process continues here, 3, 13, 3, 10, common difference is 7, so 13, here 20, further there is also one term 52, clear? Now, all these three APs having the first term, having the first common term is 52. And their common difference here for the first AP is 1. And for the second AP, common difference is 2. For the third AP, common difference is 3. Now, what will the common difference of the AP of the common terms? The common difference CD of common terms, yani common difference of the AP of common terms, yeah, CD likhte hain, common difference of common terms, common term AP, that will be LCM of, LCM aayega kis kis ka, 1, 2, 3, sorry, here 1, 2, 3 not, so common difference is 3, 5, 7. So 357, so 105. So what will the AP of common term? AP of common term. Common term, 52. First term is the 52. Which term is the common to all these three APs? 52. So first term is 52. Now common difference of the AP of common terms. 105. So second term is 107. Clear? Hai? So 157. Clear? Hai? So now in this way you will have the AP of the common terms. So you have A is here, A is 52. And what is the common difference? D is 105. So we have to find out the A plus D. A plus D is nothing, this is the second term. So A plus D, here we have 157. So now this is the answer to your last question of the first paper, that is 157. Okay.